Well, good morning, my beautiful, sexy friends. We just got some Starbucks.
Yes.
Because our new house does not have any coffee. So we decided we'd just grab a bunch of coffee, take it home, put it in a mug, and start our day off. But welcome to a full day of eating. So as you can see here, we have a nice bowl of some soy yogurt. So I don't know if you guys saw what I did there, but I threw some soy yogurt in there, and then I threw a scoop and a half of the Viva Life gingerbread protein in there. I toasted some oats that have some cinnamon, and then I threw some blueberries in on the other side, and then I put a little bit of some stevia on top of everything to sweeten it up a little bit. Super, super good. Yeah, so this is breakfast. Good way to start the morning along with the coffee here. We're gonna show you the house in a little bit. This is a recipe that I feel like all of the non-vegan fitness world is used to. It's called protein fluff, and it's just like a nice way to get a little like a sweet decadent dessert type thing, but that packs a bunch of protein. This is unsweetened, so there's no sugar in anything like that. Really, really good. You should definitely try this out. And then on my side over here, Sammy's working on her channel.
Hello.
She's editing a video right now.
Yep.
And so I'll eat this, and then after I eat this, yeah, we'll give you a little tour. Sammy just got basically like a Polaroid camera, and she's loving it so far. We just took a picture. It's developing. Not completely developed yet, but that's really, really cool. I feel like Polaroids are sick because they have like a certain style to them.
I have an art journal that I've been putting them in, so that's really exciting. I've been painting, and I got an art journal, and I've been trying to be more creative. That's my goal this year.
And now I'm gonna give you guys a little tour of our beach house here. Cue that music! You've heard of peaceful meditation yoga, but have you ever heard of yoga with a garbage man in the background? We're gonna do a little bit of yoga and some stretching here. So we are definitely on vacation.
Yes, we are.
Sure. Also, I wanted to ask you guys some questions in this because on my Instagram, I do lots of polls and people really like it. So I thought I'm gonna ask a couple questions in all of my full day of eatings just for fun. So the first one, because I was wearing a Darth Sidious hood earlier, I was thinking if you guys were in the Star Wars universe, do you think you would be Sith or Jedi?
What would you be?
What do you guys,
for sure.
What do you guys think I would be?
I know what you would be.
Yeah, I'd want to be a Sith, but I'd be a Jedi.
You'd be a Jedi. I'd be a Sith for sure.
For sure.
For sure.
All right, so we're going to sit in the koozie for a little bit. Yeah, we'll catch up with you guys, see what we do next.
Yeah.
So nice, though. We are really enjoying this weekend. All right, so it is time for lunch. So we have some things in the frying pan. So we have some broccoli and some mushrooms. I feel like a samurai right now with this pose. And then we're just heating up some already cooked quinoa right here. And then in the oven, I have a sweet potato that's baking at 420 degrees for about 45 minutes. In a second, this will all be done, and then I'll construct it with you guys. We're gonna make a really delicious bowl. It's gonna be really good. It's looking pretty dank. All right, so now everything's loaded up, and now we just gotta sauce it. So if I was at my own regular house with all my ingredients and stuff, I would make a lemon sauce, probably add some of that soy yogurt with some lemon juice and some spices and stuff and make something. But since we're not, we're just going to use this Whole Foods brand light balsamic vinaigrette. This stuff is really, really, really good. One of my favorite dressings and stuff. So I'm gonna put some of this on this salad and then some up here as well. Maybe a little bit too much both. Big old steaming bowl of deliciousness. Really exciting because I'm super hungry.
Yeah.
Sammy just had a little bite. She said,
It's good.
It's so good right now because it's so cold out. It's like a nice little warm hug to the tummy. So what's been going on lately with our diet and stuff is that during the Christmas holidays, during that last 2 weeks of December, we just say, just enjoy your life. Mm-hmm. You know, that whole balance thing of like, sometimes you gotta be on your diet and be as healthy as possible. Sometimes you gotta just whatever.
Mm-hmm.
What'd we do?
We enjoyed ourselves quite a bit.
We had some gingerbread cookies.
Yes,
we had a gingerbread house.
Yes, we had the whole house.
A little reindeer and maybe a dog. We had a lot of gingerbread.
Girl, we had a lot.
I wanna know what you guys think about this really loud airplane. If you guys had the option to never have to cook again and food was just instantly done and stuff, would you do that? Or do you enjoy the cooking, the whole thing, just like me? Because I really enjoy it.
I'm not a cooker. I do not like to cook.
A cooker.
I'm happy that he cooks.
It's like cathartic. It's good for you. It feels good, man. So also a lot of people are probably wondering, what am I doing now with like bodybuilding? Am I bulking? Am I cutting? At the very moment right now, I'm not counting macros because as I move into a bulking period, I'm kind of eating intuitively, eating just to the point where I'm full, eating just slightly a bit more than that, and then that's it. That's the best version for me. But if you need to count calories and macros, that's totally cool. Okay, we eat this and we see what we get into.
All right, so we just sat in the jacuzzi.
Yeah, it was so nice.
Again.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do it again later, I don't know.
Probably.
As you can tell, we love jacuzzis.
Yeah.
Now we're really hungry, so now we're going to do something that's really, really good. So this is, I don't know if you've heard of this before. These are carne de soya. This is like a Mexican product, but it's basically like soy curls or like if you've heard of textured vegetable protein. Same idea. It's just like little dried pieces of defatted soy. And so it's just like super high in protein, 15 grams protein per serving. You hydrate it, and then you can turn it into whatever you want to turn it into. So we are going to hydrate this and then turn it into like a Korean barbecue kind of thing. So I'm really excited. I'll show you how this works. All right, so you get a bowl of water and we just add a bunch of soy curls to it. And the good thing is you don't have to worry about how much you're using or if you're nailing it or not. Basically, these are just going to hydrate. Once they're hydrated, after about 5-10 minutes, we can strain them and then they're ready. Basically, just like the super cheapest high protein vegan meat in the world. Definitely check out soy curls or carne de soya. Really good. All right, 10 minutes later, actually a little bit less, and this is what it's looking like. You can see they're like hydrated. There's a little bit of water in there still, but we strain them, squeeze them a little bit. Just throw them in the frying pan, and then we just cooked up some brown rice. We got that waiting, and then some vegetables to throw on. Just get our greens and some color in there as well. So we're gonna let this cook for 2 minutes each side, and then throw the sauce in. So, next meal here.
So good.
Do you really mean that?
Yeah, I love it.
Don't lie, man. Next thing we're doing is, I'm pretty excited about, we're so close to the sand, we actually get to walk the boardwalk, which is really nice. So we're gonna eat this, relax for a couple minutes here while it digests, and then we're gonna go on a little walk. I'm gonna take you guys and show you around. It's really pretty.
Oh, I'll take that. Does it say vegan and gluten-free right there? Okay.
So we just wanted something to kind of celebrate what we got done last year and enjoy ourselves. And this is the last time we drink for a very long time. Don't put it on the channel very often, but right now we have some Stella Rose, Ruby Rosé, grapefruit. It's vegan, it's delicious. And we're gonna go on a little bit of a walk right now. Dinner time, and this is one of my favorite super simple dinners. These are just tostadas. So where we grew up in San Diego, we're really close to Mexico, so there's tons of Mexican food, and tostadas are something I grew up with. So basically, we got some vegetarian, which are vegan, refried beans right here. We're gonna put these, I already heated these up in the microwave, we're gonna put these on the tostadas. Then over here we have vegan carne asada, which is so good, from Cena Vegan in LA, which is a restaurant. And then we have la salsa chilena, which is one of my favorite salsas ever. Has no sodium, which is really cool. And finally we have some cilantro that I cut up. So we're just gonna construct these. It's really dope because they're so good, but it takes like literally minimal effort. It's like a sandwich, it's so easy. Guys, and that is it. Dinner is served. Oh, I've got this little light thing going on here. All right, I gotta be down here. But yeah, dinner served. It looks really good. Of course, it's gonna be delicious. The salsa that I'm using is one of my favorites, other than my own homemade pico de gallo and like one other brand. So I'm really pumped about it. So we're about to eat real good tonight. And the last thing I'm gonna have is a little sparkling water. If you guys know me, you know I have an addiction. Actually, me and Sammy both have an addiction to sparkling water. And then I'm gonna have probably this Nugo. Actually, have any of you guys heard about this? This is one of our favorite protein bars. It's called Nugo. They have a couple flavors that are vegan, not all of them, but chocolate pretzel is, and it's, drop the mic. It's good. Sammy really likes it. She's nodding.
It's amazing.
It's really good. If you enjoyed this video, give it a big old thumbs up. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. If you haven't checked out my recipe book yet, what are you doing? Check it out. It's got 39 super delicious recipes. It's gonna make life a lot easier for you. You don't have to have any cooking skill or anything like that. And they all have calories and macros on each recipe, which makes it way easier for people who are interested in seeing what's in there. And you know, people who are into fitness and stuff like that. So check that out. It's eatveganordietrying.com. Put the link in the description below. Subscribe if you guys have not subscribed already. And we will see you in the very next video. Peace.
Team Beyond the Week.